One time I joined in some tribe also. disagreed with some aspects. It was some pride and I pulled out. But that sub tribe, especially, has made a very significant. We are writing a small article for tomorrow or something. You know, Katumba told me about it, and I wrote something which will appear in one of the publications. But I want to stand here today at this point to the work of the sub tribe to which my mother belonged. As Rumai, one of them was saying here, for them, they don't think about tribes. The Maroko. For them, all God and Yesu. My father was not who only read the catechism. You could never tell about when you are going to be a father, no. You will be a sea. You will be according to her. What mattered was all God and Jesus. Our brethren and sisters in Christ. That's what mattered to them. So, the Barofoe had a very important group in civilizing Uganda. I don't have time, but if I have time, I will tell you how they helped to modernize that part of the southwest and call it Jesse. Those people there were quite wild, those were not people. But the local, for I'll give you an example. Those Wanyangole would drink milk without boiling it. It was the Moroccan who led the crusade to say, no, you must boil milk. Because milk, if you don't boil it, it has got the diseases and so on and so forth. So therefore, a pastor like he preached when my mother died. He came to Rochelle and preached, he wanted to preach. And you could see his message, the message of love for him. The message of God. The message of God, a message of loving man, but the message also of modernization. So I was very happy to be associated with him, to know him and to work with him. The other little problem I used to have with the Barongo, well, I have two problems with them. One was the book of Matthew, which they did not read very well. The great is saying that when something hits you, they want to die. I said, that has to be there. I said, that's what I cannot accept. That was 1965. I said, no. We have the traveling secretary of the Scripture Union, somebody called Albert Taylor. I disagreed with him. I was 20, I said, no, that one I cannot accept. I said, I know a lot of work has been done, but I will now meet the Archbishop in Kagari, find out what is needed. And then we can support that one. I'm not very active in the church now. I just saw 2 times in the year. On Christmas and on Easter. My wife is more active. But when we go, Chevanyoma, the Biafri, who are backbenchers in the church. When the problem of AIDS came, I was very worried about AIDS. You remember our method of communion in those days? We were sharing the cup. I was very worried. I said, naturally, this shed will be cut. There is a lot of danger. You are going to spread disease in the name of God. So I talked about it. I talked with my friend here, Geraldine, Bishop inside Kauma. I said, please, this one I'm not comfortable. I don't like this shed in the car. I talked to Archbishop Nkoyoyo, and they changed. They changed, they washed their hands. Each one has got his own cup. Name of us that we never know. Thank you very much for listening to something who is not very, very, very. Who is not very prominent in the church, but definitely that is. So I was very happy with their approach, their humility. Because the Bible says, blessed are the humble. So the kingdom of heaven is there. The one who wants to know everything, want to know, please. So I came here to give testimony. I don't have enough time. I have written something and to only console the family, but they don't give consideration because they are just strong. Ruth, no worry. I'm not going to give you this. Why? May the Almighty God rest his soul in eternal peace.